Praise the Lord. I'm Pastor Kevin Williams Jr., a pastor here at Greater Bible Way Temple of Albion. We are located at 402 Austin Avenue in Albion, Michigan, 49224. We would love for you to come out and see our service or even visit our YouTube channel, different social medias, where our sermons, our Bible studies, and many services are listed for your enjoyment to help you get through your daily trials and tribulations. And also make sure you subscribe. And don't forget to visit our website, gbwtalbion.org. We love you and God bless you. And hopefully we see you soon. Got up. And we are excited about God getting up. Because without him defeating death, we would not have the opportunity of salvation. We have the opportunity for eternal paradise due to the fact that he laid down his life for all of us. And without him laying down his life, taking our sins to the cross, and taking sickness, heartache, and pain to the cross. The Bible says it clearly, by his stripes we are healed. So this was a huge sacrifice. The Bible says that God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son. So that is a huge sacrifice. I don't know many people that would give their only son and sacrifice for us. So we just thank God for that on today. And we're very thankful on today. We want to extend our invitation to all those in the area of Albion, Parma, Marshall, Battle Creek, Jackson, Homer, that's looking for a church home, that's looking for a church. We invite you to our church, Greater Bible Way Temple of Albion, 402 Austin Avenue in the city of Albion, Michigan. We thank God that God has allowed us to stay open during the entirety of the pandemic, and our doors is open. We're here every Tuesday, 7:30, and we're here every Sunday, 12 p.m. So don't be a stranger. At this time, I want to invite the praise team to come. They're going to sing Minister Grump, an A and B selection. We only have a small portion of our praise team here on today. So we're going to ask them if they had come at this time and grace us with the blessings from God. Amen.
Now
turn with me to the Gospel according to St. Mark. We are interested in chapter number 16.
Evangelist,
even those that was close in relationship, Mary and Mary Magdalene, that went there to anoint him with sweet spices, you can see their reaction, that they didn't even think that Jesus Christ will rise from the grave. But I'm so glad. It doesn't matter what people think that determines what Jesus Christ does. You can think bad on Jesus Christ all you want. Put naysays to him. Put limits on him. What he can do. What he can't do. He showed the whole world what he can do. And for some of us, it's getting older. That may start to forget certain things. It's written down in his word. That you can see what Jesus Christ did over 2,000 years ago. I feel like preaching in this apostolic church on Easter Sunday. Across the world, many of us growing up, Easter was one of the best church holidays that our parents, no matter their financial situations, because most of us came from struggling families that was not rich. Didn't have very much. I know certainly my upbringing was not one of a silver spoon. Amen. Regardless of what you see, what God is doing on the life of myself and my wife, I come from poor backgrounds. Amen. But somehow, some way, my mother and father was able to create a little extra finances for me and my siblings. Yes. That we would get a suit, or get a dress for my sister, and then we would come to church. And we would have our Easter speeches, similar to the children that came here today at Greater Bible Way Temple, that said some positive things about Jesus Christ. You can say a lot of negative things about Kevin Williams Jr., because I'm flawed. But there ain't a lot of negative things you can say about Jesus Christ. And I thank God that I had that upbringing. Although I was not perfect, from then to now, I came to church, not just on Easter, but we was in Vacation Bible School. We was in Christian Education Sunday School.
I'll say, come on.
From a baby, from Sister Taylor's grandchild, since I was her age, we would come to church. This was a tradition set in place that no matter what's going on in your life, we will celebrate Jesus Christ getting up out of that grave. No matter what you're going through, your struggles, no matter what you're envisioning, your heartaches, your pains, your feelings and the emotions that this world embraces and embarks on us, we gonna go to church on Easter and celebrate Jesus Christ getting up from the grave.
Amen.
Even if we don't go to church on no other Sunday, on this Sunday, we don't put on our Sunday's best. And celebrate Jesus Christ getting up from the grave. Am I in the right church on this Sunday morning? Somebody say, rise and shine. Could you imagine going to the cemetery or the gravesite of your loved one? Because simply this was what Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James and Salome, these were actually Jesus' relatives. When you do your study in your Bible, you will see that the majority of the disciples were related to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I wish I was talking to somebody to understand what's going on today. When Jesus Christ went to the cross and shed that blood covered us all. So when we in the body of Christ, no matter your color, your race, your ethnicity, your culture, we brothers and sisters in the body of Christ. We are all related. Those that have experienced salvation, accepted Jesus Christ in their life, baptized in water, receiving the precious gift of the Holy Ghost, that makes you my brother. That makes you my sister.
Yes, yes. Yes.
By his stripes,
yes,
we are healed.
Yes.
I was talking to a gang member, mm-hmm. and they asked me, hey, brother, what gang do you represent? And I said, I represent the blood gang. And he said, well, who beat you in? Right? Because, you know, when you're in a gang, you get beat in. I said, I didn't get beat in, but the one that put me in is the big homie. I represent the blood gang. Because I'm covered by his blood. And I talked about on Friday that it was something about them church mothers, the missionaries growing up, they were singing them blood songs.
Yes, yes.
It was something about the anointing that you would feel. I like Kirk Franklin, I like Fred Hammond, I like Lecrae, I like Bizzle. But I don't hear the anointing or feel it when I'm listening to them songs. It's something about the blood of Jesus that makes a difference in the atmosphere. When I was feeling pain in my back, and they began to sing those blood songs, I could feel the pain leaving my back. Rise and shine. We ain't got no excuses no more. We serve the most mighty and powerful God. What kind of man is this that can lay down his life and 3 days later get up from the grave? He didn't need nobody to pump blood in him, because he shed his blood for all of us. Wasn't no Everlast 2,000 years ago to transport him from the hospital to the world. It was nothing but the power of Jesus Christ that got them devils scared, got them demons scared. You don't stand a chance against the God I serve. He's a mighty God, an almighty present God. We'll be there in the time of struggle. We'll be there in the time of need. I'm here to tell you, rise and shine. Get up from your situation. The Bible says, faith without works is dead. We got the power because of Jesus Christ. What he did for us on the cross, took our sins to the cross. He took lying to the cross. He took stealing to the cross. He took murder to the cross. We gotta tell the judge, let me out this prison. I've been pleading not guilty by his blood that he shed on Calvary. I feel like going to the shepherd's place, but I feel the might that I can overcome the devil and all his games and all his gimmicks and all his mousetraps that he's trying to set against me and my family. You can't have me. I'm covered by the blood. You can't destroy me. I'm covered by the blood. You can't defeat me. I'm covered by the blood. This is a blood game. Throw up your side. Jesus Christ. That's who I rep. And that's who I represent. Jesus Christ. Put your hands together. Then see it at the end of the verse 2, they came into the sculpture at the rising mm-hmm. of the sun. Sun, day.
Okay.
Now you understand the revelation all today. God has placed his victory in our American culture that every Sunday the devil got a reminder of what happened 2,000 years ago. Every Sunday, the devil is reminded that he thought he had the victory. But I played sports in high school. I played sports in college. Sometimes those games go into overtime. Sometimes the team may have momentum. But when you get in overtime, it's mano a mano. It's a new start. So the devil might have had a game plan for regular simulation. But when it came to that overtime, the way that Jesus Christ performed was better than Babe Ruth, was better than Aaron Rodgers, was better than Brett Favre. Verse 8 says in went out quickly and fled from the soldier, for they trembled and were amazed. Neither said they anything to any man, for they were afraid. If you don't have a relationship with Jesus Christ, you should be afraid.
Amen.
After everything that Jesus Christ have done for us, there is no excuse for you not to have salvation. Everything that we have witnessed in the last 3 years, even the things that's going on now, this is not a time to run away from the church or run away from God. This is a time to run towards God.
Yes, sir.
I'm telling you now, I don't know how much time we have. I can't give you extra days of life. I don't have that power. I don't know if you will be here tomorrow. I don't know if any of us will be here tomorrow. Because the Bible says he's coming back for a church without spot or wrinkle. The Bible also says no man knows the hour. So we have to prepare for that time. And the way you prepare is building a closer relationship with Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That's praying, reading your word, fasting, coming to church, fellowshipping, believe it or not, because believers need to fellowship with one another. Just like most of us about to fellowship with our family, it's also important that we fellowship with one another.
Amen.
To help each other and encourage each other get through these troubled times. Amen?
Amen.
And a lot of us in the church, we have different gifts and talents that we bring to the body of Christ. We need to share that and not be selfish what God has given us, that we may be able to better the body of Christ and not take away or quench the Holy Spirit. So I understand that we have problems. I understand that we have issues. But I'm here to tell you that the power that Jesus Christ has will allow all of us to rise and shine. Come on, put your hands together and give God a hand, praise.